Welcome back to New Rock Stars. I'm Eric Voss, and this is a breakdown of Free Guy, starring Ryan Reynolds as a non-playable character in a Fortnite-style game who gains AI sentience. This movie is filled with Easter eggs and references to games and nerdy movies, and a spoiler warning, while any obvious sighting of Captain America's shield turns parts of us into dude versions of those parts, what impressed me more about this film is the subtle ways the filmmakers designed Free City to have a simulated feel in order to better reflect Guy's Truman Show Matrix reality. So let's go back through this movie to discuss some stuff that you might have missed. The opening scene glides down into Free City, similar to the way players drop into Fortnite, with Channing Tatum playing the badass sunglassed hero Guy wishes he was. Down on the street, things take a Grand Theft Auto turn when he detaches his parachute on the police car windshield, causing it to spin out. And from this madness, the camera moves into Guy's bedroom window through the blinds, which we later learn are the key evidence to Million Keys' original game code Paradise Island, which is accessible through a barrier like the barrier we just passed through. The solution to the problem in the opening minute of the film. Now, the film's production designer, Ethan Topman, designed Guy's apartment with the idea that as an NPC, Guy would have a fixed amount of gigabytes for his home life. So his books behind his bed have no titles on them. His pantry only has cereal and a single spoon. His calendar over his TV is missing the fourth day of the month. And the dominoes on his table are arranged in a loop, reflecting how the steps of his day are just one inevitable cascade into the next, circling back on itself. Also, his front door has 5 deadbolts, but no knob. At the coffee shop, the board reads weak coffee, strong coffee, really good coffee, really hot coffee, really dark coffee, and really weak coffee, which are all just pretty much variants of the same thing. And then on the other side of the board, there's coffee, coffee with milk, and coffee without milk, which is just coffee, but still all listed separately. And then as he leaves his shop, there is a character glitch outside of the background, an extra repeatedly running into the bins. The Big Ups shoes that he wants to buy have a string of binary code on the sole. And when Guy checks the ATM, stomping around in the background, looks like either a Metal Gear Rex or a Harvester Bot from Terminator Salvation. Now, Molotov Girl is played by Jodie Comer, who also plays Millie, and at first looks like very different characters. The tipster that she meets in the alleyway is actually a vocal cameo by Hugh Jackman. Guy passes Molotov Girl on the street as she sings Mariah Carey's Fantasy, the song that he wakes up to every morning because, as we learn later, Keys programmed him to fall in love with a dream girl with qualities based on Millie's quirks. And as he looks at her, behind him in the background, there's another player who just kind of swings their arms aimlessly. And they stand next to a storefront with a sign reading, "Your loan is already approved, this store is a scam." As Guy follows her, behind him is the Halo Scorpion tank. It actually shows up a few times throughout the film. And in the bank, the skull masked robber is actually a vocal cameo by Dwayne The Rock Johnson.
"I'll give them right back."
I said no!
Now, when Guy first puts on the Taken sunglasses, you can see on his menu his one move is harmless slap, and among his inventory is a paperclip, a receipt, and a metro pass, just stuff he would already have on him. Nearby is a trash bin that is filled with these orange coffee cups, since every NPC in Free City drinks the same medium coffee, one cream, two sugars. After stealing the money from Tuxedo Baby, the carjacking victim in the background does this kind of awkward adjustment as his hands are up, kind of like NPCs sometimes do as you're stealing their car. Guy walks down the street marveling at the new graphics he can see, including this gin bottle with a subtle product placement. Stranger Things actor Joe Keery plays Keys, a programmer for Tsunami Games head Antoine, played by Taika Waititi. Keys goes into the game to try to stop Guy. Guy flees, he misses the wrecking ball, bounces safety, but then just gets hit by the car. Anyway, Molotov Girl takes Guy into her stash house, which from the outside is just a small shipping container, but is way bigger on the inside, like many of the stash houses in this game, which is actually a choice by the production designers. They were following by the rules of impossible geography and physics in a video game. As Guy gets more popular, we get all these cameos from gaming personalities like Ninja, Jacksepticeye, DanDTM, Laserbeam, and Pokimane. Actually, John Krasinski cameos as that silhouetted gamer in the interview. The late Alex Trebek brings him up in an episode of Jeopardy. Actually, one of the categories there is Famous Blakes, a nod to Ryan Reynolds' wife, actress Blake Lively. Also, the avatar who kicks Guy in the balls looks a lot like Serena from Gossip Girl. That's Blake Lively's character. Guy does a bunch of good deeds, like extinguishing a fella who's constantly on fire, just for that poor guy to get shot and teabag shortly after. Hey, by the way, men's bodies change and become less efficient over time. It's not just older folks either. Tens of millions of men experience low testosterone and hormone imbalances. That's probably at least one reason Tony Stark had to go through all those suit designs. I bet the nanostructure of that Mark 85 suit did more than just repel energy blasts. Well, thanks to Hone for sponsoring this video. Hone helps men recognize potential hormone deficiencies and restore their hormone health and testosterone levels with proven treatments. Optimizing your hormones and testosterone has positive effects on your health, including giving you more energy. As someone who works long hours, the last thing I would want to hamper my energy level is a treatable hormone imbalance. Hone treats your health with real physicians, real science, and real pharmaceutical medications. Now, I'm no medical expert, but Hone Health is, and they'll be there with you every step of the way. Order Hone's easy-to-use at-home assessment to get your energy back and feel like yourself again, or better. So this is the at-home kit. Comes with everything you need, very clear instructions to take your assessment, comes with the stuff you need to take your sample, the bag to put it back in, and the pre-stamped shipping label so that you can mail it back in and get your results. This is first-class medical service from the privacy of your home. Their products and treatments are prescribed by a physician who consults with you by telehealth. Real doctors, real medicine, real treatments, real results. Click the link in the description box or go to honehealth.com/rockstars to save 25% on your home assessment test with free shipping. While helping Millie get the file, Guy uses a Mega Man-style arm blaster, and then at this moment among his inventory, we see he has more paper clips. They escape through the window, gliding away on a Fortnite parachute glider. In Guy's stash house, there's a space shuttle pod with both American and Canadian flags, a nod to Ryan Reynolds' Canadian background. In Millie's apartment, there is some art on the wall showing a boy playing with Iron Giant. And can we please stop forcing Iron Giant Easter eggs in all these Easter egg movies? Let Superman rest in peace. Molotov girl takes Guy into the tavern, where she finally tells him the nature of his reality. On the leaderboard, you can see the top player is Tuxedo Baby, that same player who crash-landed in front of Guy earlier whose money he took. I guess they're back at the top. But that might be because on the other side of the bar is that skull-masked bank robber. That could be Tuxedo Baby using this skin, since the other players used that skin died earlier. So then Guy freaks out and goes out in the middle of the street, gets double hit by cars, which is a nod to Brad Pitt's memorable death in Meet Joe Black. They meet Channing Tatum's character again. He's actually played by a nerd, played by actor Maddie Carter-Ripple, Keith in Stranger Things alongside Joe Keery, which is produced by this movie's director, Sean Levy. Meanwhile, Tina Fey cameos as his vacuuming mom. In his bedroom are posters for Avengers Infinity War, Deadpool, of course it's a Ryan Reynolds movie, gotta work Deadpool in there, Rick and Morty, an X-Files I Want to Believe poster, Joust, there's a Joker Funko Pop back there, and a convention badge hanging up, and then on his desk is Jack Skellington, and a book for D&D Dungeon Masters, my kinda dude. And then as Guy leaves, Channing Tatum seems to improvise a reference to Thanos' gauntlet. Now Antoine has the game rebooted, Molotov kisses Guy to restore his memory, and they rally the other NPCs to go on strike. They drive through the collapsing city, and Keys builds a ramp for them, but the VFX team of this movie intentionally put under that ramp blank blue sky, which they talked about in an interview, because you don't develop crust magma in a video game, and like in the Truman Show, behind the curtain there would be nothing there. Antoine unleashes the unfinished upgrade dude, with Ryan Reynolds' face layered on bodybuilder and pro wrestler Aaron Reed. The guy is 6'7". As he approaches Guy with the death blow, he does this kind of like arm pump move. That was Henry Cavill's move from Mission Impossible Fallout. His underwear reads game over. Guy gets his ass handed to him as Millie and others plead him to get up. Similar to Trinity in The Matrix begging Neo, who was down in the simulated reality, to get up and fight back.
Now get up.
And Guy does fight back using Captain America's freaking shield, along with Hulk's arm, and Alan Silvestri's Avengers theme plays here. And amazingly, Chris Evans cameos watching all this from a coffee shop saying, "What the shit?" According to Ryan Reynolds, he knew Chris Evans just happened to be in Boston on the day they were shooting, and he texted him asking if he wanted to come help them out with a simple cameo, and Evans is like, "I got 10 minutes. And they made it work. He agreed, he showed up, and they got him in and out in under 7 minutes. Why couldn't they do that for the Falcon and the Winter Soldier? I guess because he would have had to be an old man. And if that's not enough, Guy ignites a lightsaber as a Star Wars theme plays. But I love how he holds that handle below frame, allowing it to erect from a very Spaceballs angle as he raises his eyebrows suggestively. Then the lightsaber turns into the Rainbow Smash pickaxe from Fortnite, delivers a major blow, then he turns it into the gravity gun, and then he uses the portal gun. But Guy ends up defeating the dude by putting his sunglasses on him, sharing his vision with him. And notice how dude's inventory includes a tub of whey protein. Antoine tries to wreck the servers, but Guy makes it all the way to the island, giving Millie and Keys their victory. And it is revealed what I actually thought was pretty obvious throughout the film, that Guy was Keys' sort of love letter to Millie. And Guy and Buddy live on peacefully in their Sims-like paradise. You can support new rock stars by checking out our merch options, including our brand new Marvel What If limited edition shirt at newrockstarsmerch.com. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at EAVoss. Follow and subscribe to New Rock Stars. Thanks for watching. Bye.